We have Imran Khan, Manager of Business Development at NCDEX AgriVex, who's joining in. Overall, Imran, first, if you could just help us understand as well, what is this that NCDEX has introduced? What are the launch timelines, etc.?
Hello, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yeah, pardon. Can you
Yes, you're audible, Imran.
Okay. Hi, good afternoon, everyone, and really sorry for some technical glitch, and we are starting a little late. And first of all, thank you very much for joining this session. And as today we are going to discuss about the AgriDex future specifically. AgriDex is nothing but the indices for the NCDEX, like Sensex and Nifty for BSE, NSE. Here, two, three things I just have to mention that we have already got the approval for the futures launch, but just awaited for some other development, and we will soon launching it. So, can I start
Yes,
now,
yeah.
sir?
So b before you start, Hiral, and I will just brief our team. In between the slides, whenever you are giving a presentation, if somebody is having a query, they can write it. Hiral will address that queries to Mr. Imran. So if somebody is having any difficulties, they can ask us, and we can ask after turning a slide. So that will be very useful, because it doesn't make sense to go back again if you not understand the first slide only. So this is very interesting for commodities. After a long wait, we are getting the indices to trade on. So I think without wasting it, I'll just hand over to Hiral. Hiral will just say what needs to be done. We should start, Hiral, then.
Sure.
Yeah, Imran, you can start.
Yeah. So as you can see on the you can see on the screen that this is the first kind of return-based indices in India, agricultural indices in India, which is the return-based. And what exactly it means by return-based, we will see into the coming slide. So AgriDex futures, what you see in the current slide, there are six major important factors in it. First is the component, okay, how actually we have composed this particular indices. So when SEBI gives the approval for the indices, they have come out with some criteria. So the first criteria is that the out of total 100% indices, 80% of the indices values underlying should be crossing or having at least 75 crore and above ADTV. Say suppose, for example, we having 10 commodities in this particular indices. So out of 10, 8 commodities should be having 80% and above, 75 crore and above ADTV. ADTV means average daily traded volume of that particular commodity. So apart from that criteria, one more criteria is there. If we cross 80% of the we get the 80% criteria with 75 crore and above ADTV, for rest 20%, we can add below 75 crores commodity as well. So this is the basic criteria for the components underlying commodities. The second thing is the value weighted. Okay, how we have calculated the value and how we have given the weightage for the different commodities, because every commodity is having its own production value and the liquidity into the market. So what we did, 50-50% is the weightage we have given both for the production as well as the liquidity. So how we are have calculated it, we will see into the coming slide. But for production value, we have taken last 5 years production value weight, and for liquidity we have taken last 12 months, last 1 year ADTV average liquidity of that particular underlying future respectively. third whim is the flooring and capping. So what we did ki for every each single commodity who is having, we are having into this indices, so every commodity having the flooring and capping in terms of percentage. So flooring will be at around 20%, and the capping is around on the at the 20%, and the flooring is around at the 3%. So no commodity will having the weightage above 20% or below 3%. It will be between these. And the reason to introduce this that it should not like that any commodity dominate indices. So weightage means you can consider in equities like beta, we consider a beta. So here we use weightage word for the same.
So each commodity has a certain weight. So for example, right now, can you explain how the entire index is formed?
Yeah. So we have selected 10 liquid commodities, top 10 liquid commodities, first of all. And what we did that we have taken last 5 years production value of that particular each commodity. And for each commodity, we have given 50% weightage for the production value and 50% weightage for the liquidity for the last 12 months. And into that, each commodity having their own production value. So basis on that, there is a calculation in coming slides. I will explain in detail how we have calculated that weightage.
Okay.
Yeah. So one important thing is there, it's rebalancing. So rebalancing is nothing but what we are going to do that to addition new commodities into the indices, or deletion of the indices, older commodities, and weighted changes as per their production values and their liquidity get changed. So what is rebalancing and when we are going to take it in consideration? So the period for the rebalancing will be taken into consideration from January to December, last 1 year. And it will be happening, we are going to be disclosed to the market that which new commodities and which new weightages are going to be introduced from 1st of April. So 3 months advance, we are giving the information to the market ki what changes is going to be happen into the indices weightage and the commodities. Next is rollover. This is very important part. That the basic difference in the our indices is that its underlying is the future contract, not the spot. Like in equities, you can see the underlying is the cash instrument, but here we are having a future. We don't trade into spot at our platform. So when we talk about the future, so it is going to be expired every month, and when it is going to be expire, it is going to be having the cash cost of carry for the next month, or we can say the yield, which is going to be impact on it. So this is the return based indices. So rollover, what we will see the exactly rollover how it works, but the rollover will happen on the first 3 days of the month of expiry contract. Like for example, say suppose soybean is going to be expire in the month of June. So 20th June is the expiry. So we are going to roll over that weightage from 1st, 2nd and 3rd June. Equally, one third of the value is going to be get rollover every day. For example, if say suppose total 100% weightage is for soybean only. So what we'll do on day one closing, on the basis of closing, we will consider 33.33% weightage shifted to the next near month contract. It might be happen that after June, we are having the contract of July or maybe August. So whichever is the next contract, that will be the taken into the consideration. And first day, after the first day's closing, we will took that one third position into next contract. So what will happen into indices value second day, that 66.67% weightage value will arrive from the June month, and 33% weightage will arrive from the next month contract, which is July. So on second day closing, what we will do, we will divide into two, like 66.67% weightage is going to be divided into two, which will be the one third of the total 100%. to the next month contract on day 3rd. The indices value will derive on the basis of June month 33% and 66.67% from the July contract. On 3rd day closing, same similar will happen, total 100% means 33% remaining we will shift into the next month contract, and total value on the day 4 will arrive from the July month contract, and the current month contract of June will don't have any impact on the indices values. Hope it's clear.
Yes, so basically what you are trying to say is that on every 1st of April, the index component will be restructured. And 3 months prior to that, everyone will be informed. And the rollover is going to be done in the first 3 days of the expiry month.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
Actually, in rollover, it might be possible, say suppose we are in April right now. In the month of, right now, we are at 24th April. So right now, indices value are going to be derived from the May contract. But say suppose out of that 10 commodities, if 2 commodities are there who don't have the May contract, it is having a June contract. So that will be become a near month contract, and the value derives from that month only. And when the restructuring will happen in the month of May 1st, 2nd and 3rd, those 2 contracts is not going to be considered.
So friends, this is the explanation how this index is made. In order to understand, this is not going to help us in, this is only to help us understand. When it comes to the trading, we are not have to go into nitty-gritties. The rollover and everything really take place. We don't have to worry about that. But this is just the understanding how the index is formed and how the constituents are derived and when it is going to be restructured.
Yes, this is just for understanding, because it is going to be happen internally. You will be informed, market will be informed in advance for the same. I think one last point was remain in the last slide. So that one is the commodity selection. So what commodity selection we have did into it, I said ki, there is a criteria of 75 crore and above ADTV, first criteria. So the remaining 20% we have shared which sectors are not coming under the 75 crore and above commodity. So we have added some spices like dhania and zira into it.
Yeah. Okay.
So this is the production weight calculation. Exactly what we did. The production weight, what we have taken for total production value of commodities in index, and value of production. So value of production, exactly what it means, ki we have taken last 5 years value of production. Value of production means ki production plus we have taken the average spot rate for last 5 years average. Every year we have taken and we have averaged it out. So total production value of that particular commodities index, into that we have divided into it. So say suppose, for example, soybean having the 18% weightage. For that value, we have divided 50% of that, we have divided into 100 of the total indices value.
So this is the product weight. Each and every commodity is having certain weight. So how that weight is derived? So that is the this is the calculation, value of production divided by the total value of commodities launched in NCDX platform.
Absolutely.
Okay.
Now this is for the liquidity weight calculation. As I said, ki we have taken last 12 months future underlying data value. So this is how we have calculated the liquidity weight. So 50% production weight and 50% liquidity weight is there. So liquidity weight calculation formula is this, that we have taken the liquidity weight from traded value divided by the total trade value of the commodities in indices.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyone having query can immediately post. Either me or Hiral will ask you what needs to be done.
So this is CIP calculation actually means commodity index percentage, which is the 100%. But what we have exactly did, we have discussed is all, it's already that total commodities indexes percentage will be equal to 0.05 into CLP. CLP means the commodities liquidity percentage, and the CPP means commodities production percentage. So this will be the calculation for it. So here we come that these are the sectors for the all agri commodity. These are the seven different sectors like sugar, soft, then edible oils, pulses, industrial products, grains, cotton, spices, and these commodities are coming under this particular sector. So what exactly this sector will help us? Ki we have ensured that diversification into the indices, and no sector will dominate the indices more than 40%. So we have put the capping for the sector as well. Like we have put the flooring and capping for individual commodities, we also have capped the sectorial commodities capping as well.
What is the maximum individual commodity wise weightage any commodity can have?
20% maximum into indices.
Okay.
Not more than 20%.
And what is the current weightage of each commodity?
We will coming on that. So these are the percentage of out of all 10 commodities. These are the most liquid commodities, and we have given the percentage of weightage. This is the weighted percentage for each commodity. So if you can see here, soybean having the maximum percentage 18.43%. I will give you one example. We all know that in India, maximum production of the agriculture commodity is wheat and then sugar. So you can see here, there is no wheat, no sugar. The reason is we have given the equal weightage 50% for liquidity as well as the production value. So there are some instruments which having good liquidity but not much the production value, but they are not into it. And those are having good, very good production values but no liquidity into the market, futures market, we have not included that. So you can see there is no sector like oil and oilseed sector participating more into it, but it is not more than 40%.
Correct me if I'm not getting it wrong. So for example, like you said, wheat is the volume wise biggest commodity. But since we are not having adequate volume, that is not included in the
production wise is the biggest commodity. But in terms of the our platform, that trading volume means liquidity is not much.
Okay,
that's why it's not there.
So that's how the interest of the investor is protected.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. Good. So this is the current soya bean 18%, 8% for soya refined.
Mustard. Yes. Jira second three. One is the chana, third one is the RM seed, then guar seed, and if you see, we have dhania with the 3.22%.
Okay.
If you see dhania, why it's 3.22%, there are two reasons. First, it is not coming under the category of 75 crore and above ADTV.
Okay.
And the second one, we have diversified the indices. So you can see that spices also contributing into it. Zira and dhania, both are having 3.89 and 3.22%.
Anyone having any query till now from the team? Yeah, continue.
Yeah, okay. So we were discussing about the rollover process, right? So what happened into the rollover and why it is return-based indices we have created? This is the classic example. If we invest into stock, okay, so what we do, we trade today, and whenever we want to exit, we will exit for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. There is no expiry for the stock market, cash market, right?
Right.
But when we are doing a futures trade in commodities, there are commodities. So what will happen, if I invested in this month, I have to carry it forward until or unless I have taken a 3 month, 4 month contract, because most of the people are doing trade into the current month contract as it's more liquid. Okay. So if I have taken the position in the month of April, I have to carry it over till June or July. So what I will do, I will take a position into the April month contract. When it is coming to expire, I will square that position, I will take the new position. Mm-hmm. But you can see there is a difference in prices. So suppose if the April month contract is trading at around, example, soybean is trading at around 3500. So May month contract is going to be having a different value, different price. It might be in contango at 3700, or it might be in the backwardation like 3300 or 3400. Mm-hmm. The prices will never same, right? So what will happen, when I will carry over my position, there is a yield come, either positive yield or negative yield. So if we are considering that yield, so there will be a spike or downward trend into indices as well, because the value is deriving from the underlying commodities. So what we did, we have not considered that price. We have considered the return. So for example, if the when we are rolling it over for the first 3 days, so what we are considering, say suppose the value of soybean is 4000 for the month of April, and we have to convert into the May month contract. So what we will do, the closing price of previous day, like 4000, and if the closing price of the first day is 4040, so we are not considering the 40 as a price. We will consider it a return. So it will be coming around 1% return. And similarly, in the May contract also, we are calculating the same. So what will happen, that price is not going to impact on the indices value much. Whatever percentage going to be changed into that particular commodity, that is going to be impact only into that particular indices value. So that negative yield or positive yield of that particular 2 month contract, difference between 2 month contract, will be nullified.
Okay.
Yeah. So as we discuss, it's a return-based indices. What we have taken the example here is the same example of that only. Okay, we have to every month roll it over, and that value, negative or positive, will be the impact. So you can see here, for the position initiation, I have taken the position on the 10th May. I have to square it off on the 20th May, and then we have to take the position into the next month contract.
So this index basically will be tradable on the monthly basis. Every month we'll have an expiry. Can you just?
Yes, we will have in the near month, current month, near month, and the quarterly basis of our month. We will see the calendar as well. But there is some change into the calendar, as we haven't launched yet. So first 2 months we are having, and the difference, like for example, if we are having in the month of January contract, we will have a February contract and the March contract as well.
Okay, so
but
our client...
We will be into the February contract. So February contract will be there, March contract will be there, then directly you will find the June contract.
Okay.
Quarterly.
Okay.
So when February will going to be expired, automatically April contract may get introduced.
Okay. So at the time of expiry, this new contracts will be launched.
Yes. First day of the month, the new contract will be launched.
Okay. Anyone having any query till now? Can so we can answer, because if we keep going and if you are not understanding, not having any clarity, then
if At any point, if somebody having any query, if somebody wants to explain in other language, we will explain. Yeah, please.
I think Imran, you can go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay, now this is very interesting. Everyone, please. How?
So, here, what you see the graph. This is really, as Kunal sir said, be very interesting, because you are watching it like last 4 years indices graph. Okay, so this is the graph. You can see return based graph. For example, with the very recent example we will take, in the month of February, when the Nifty made a high, Nifty started falling from 12,000. Indices is also started falling from around the 900 or something. At the same time, Nifty made a low of 7,500, and again it's bounced back to the 9,200. But if you see here, as an agri commodity, you can see the indices value has come again onto the that level which he started falling. There are two reasons behind it. First, this is not the price based indices. This is the return based indices. Means ki, say suppose soybean has started falling from the 4000 level, and it become 3900. So overall, if you see ki, we are seeing the fall of around 2.5%, right? But at the same time, if we consider into the price, it will be impact as a 100 rupees. So spike or fall will be like that only. So you can see it's in last 4 years, and every year we have considered the different values as per the criteria, and we have taken the valuation as per the guidelines only. So every year you can see that very minimal difference between the It doesn't mean it doesn't have volatility. It is having a very good volatility, average volatility of 1% every day, more than that. So the important thing is you can see the negative return also you can see here. So in terms of return, it is 6.34% minus. So return means what? Key returns it might be when you are trading in derivative. So you can go short, you can go long as well. So it is doesn't mean ki only the positive return will give you the benefit. You can take the benefit into the negative returns as well. And annualized volatility of this particular on this particular parameter is 12.54, which is for the last 1 year.
Right. In fact, Imran, I'm going to interrupt over here. There's a question coming in on the previous slide. Santosh Kohli is asking whether expiry will be every 20 days. Or on every 20th day?
Expiry for the AgriDex future will be on every last working day of the month. For example, if we trade into the May contract, the expiry will be the 30th May, or whatever it may be, the last trading day for the May month. That will be the expiry for the AgriDex future.
Okay, I hope that query has been answered on this one.
Yeah, it is not aligned with the futures contract. Expiry is separate. This contract is going to be expire every its last working day of that particular expiry month. Mm-hmm. So we have decided the last working day, not date.
Okay, you can move ahead. I think
it might be 28, 29, 30th or maybe. So you can see here in this graph, there is no much hanky-panky movements, as it's a return-based indices. And these are the returns in numbers, actually, for last 4 years. So if you can see, every month, there is a return in a different manner. So you can say some months, commodities, agri-commodities are in a positive trend. Some months are into the negative trend. So you will find the negative and positive both returns. And maximum, you can see in the month of January, there is a minus 9.74% return into it. Yeah, Kunal sir, please.
Okay, I just like to add over here, the purpose of commodity index, especially this agri commodity index, is mainly diversifying. So for example, generally agriculture commodities are into a bull run, and because of all these crises, you see agriculture commodity prices going down. So these are like a safe haven instrument. So if I'm invested, if you look at the return, you are not seeing 15%, 20%, 30% minus return, and you are not showing 20% return made also in all these numbers. So if somebody is looking for stability or 3-4%, 5% return or 2%, 3% return, then this is very good instrument. Safety of capital is relatively higher as compared to the other indexes. So if you look what has been happening in 2020, in 2019, I'm just looking at the number. The average plus or minus is not more than 5% except the January month in 2020. So you see a graph of 3 years, I don't see a number of minus 10 or plus 10. So your relative capital is preserved. So if I want to have an exposure in the agriculture commodity, and I'm not understanding which commodity to go along, whether soybean is bullish, whether cotton is bullish, whether wheat is bullish, then this is the product for me. I am buying the entire agriculture commodity basket together. And if I think that these are this time, if there is a news that the monsoon is below average or the monsoon is not keep, and then the prices will shoot up and automatically the agri-index future will shoot up. So these are the way, you know, where we can invest in it. And mostly in international market, hedge funds, mutual funds, or big players who wants to diversify their capital, their risk, they invest in this kind of indexes. Imran, you can continue.
Absolutely. Absolutely right. Yeah, you explained it, sir. Next, sir. So these are the actually not for the any other purpose, but you can see the benefit. Last slide, sir. You can see the benefit of agri commodities. So how can one take the benefit? Kunal sir, last slide, please. So like overall directional indicator, yes. So here you can see how can one trade into it and take benefits. So it will be a overall directional indicator. Last one, please.
Which one? This one.
Last one. Benefits.
The previous slide where you were on benefits. No. Slide number 5 or 6.
This is a different pivot, I think.
One minute, I'm just... This one, benefits of NCDX, AgriDex.
Overall directional indicator, then diversified basket, as we have discussed, the major all the sectors we have covered into it, like spices, grains, pulses, oil seeds, and all. Then, how can it benefit that estimation of risk and systematic risk, which Kunal sir already told that if the monsoon is the below average or above average, so we have estimate and we can take the position accordingly into the overall basket. Then apart from this, very low correlation with the other asset classes and indices. The major reason is that this one is the return-based indices, not the price-based indices. So I'll give you an example, like if we consider it into the price band, so like for example, Nifty is trading around 10,000, and if it moves to 11,000, so it will be in terms of price, it is 1,000 rupees gain, right? But if we consider into the returns, it will be only 10%. So this is the difference between the price and the return-based indices only. It is not on actual prices, but it is depend on the percentage of the movement. Then its relation with the other indices is very less. Or we can take it, for the diversification, if we are considering for investment into the basket for the diversification, you can see. So I have given you the example that most of the trades are closed now due to lockdown and all, but the government is allowing the agri commodity activities like mandis and the trading into it and the other part of the trade into agriculture commodities is there. So it's totally different and very low correlation it having into it. So it is very good for the basket of investment. Then effective benchmarking, which is, we have already taken the example. Then the real-time calculation, whatever it happened into the real-time basis, prices and its return, it is going to be calculated on it. And the most important thing, that it is going to be managed by the NSE's Indices Limited, which is the indices, it's the independent company who handles the indices. And the most importantly, it's handling the all the NSE indices, including Nifty, Bank Nifty, and M. So whatever internal changes and the calculation will happen, will going to be happen and managed by the NSE Indices Limited, and not by the NCDX. Yes, sir. Next slide, please. So these are some how can one can take benefit and trade into it. So short-term edge, short-term scalp, overall directional trade, indices, arbitrage, calendar trade, performance analysis. And the most important thing, this is the cash-settled future contract. And I'm happy to say this, that this is the first ever cash-settled future contract in NCDEX, specifically into the agri-commodities. So you don't have to bother about the delivery and staggered period and additional delivery margins and other things.
Okay.
So this is the launch calendar. Actually, there is some change into it. So I will share you the latest PPT as soon as we are going to have the launch date and all.
Okay.
This is the most important in terms of understanding for you, that these are the contract specification for Agritech future. So the type of the contract is indices future, name of indices is same and underlying is same. That ticker symbol which is going to be displayed onto your screen will be like Agritech and the expiry date of that particular month. For example, if it is 10:30, example has been given that Agritech 30th September 2019 will be appeared to the screen. That is the symbol. Then next one is that its lot size is 500 units. 500 units is the lot size and it's cash settled. Maximum order size will be 50 lots. And per unit, quotation will be base value of the per unit. And the tick size will be 25 paisa. For example, 500 unit in one lot, it means ki whatever change will happen in terms of rupee. So 500 rupees will be win-loss ratio. One rupee into five rupees.
Upside or downside in the index. On one lot, 500 rupees plus or minus.
Correct. Plus or minus. Or on a single tick. 125 rupees plus or minus will happen. Okay. 125 rupees. So, okay. This is very important for a trader. You can consider it as like, ki within a single tick, there is a, your cost will come out. If you are going to trade on a single tick as well, 125. So, there is no much costing in it. That's very important.
Okay.
If you consider or compare it with any other indices, so you will find it. Like that 500 is the lot size, and for 1 rupee, you are going to have a win-loss ratio of 500 rupees.
Okay, Imran.
Yeah, then the important thing is that last trading day that somebody asked earlier. So the expiry date will be the last trading day of the month. And trading hours will expire at,
it will expire at 5 p.m.
Yeah, it will be expiring on the expiring at 5 p.m. But it is going to be operated from 9 to 9, which is the regular time, as we are having the refined soya oil as a underlying component into it. So most of the 9 commodities are going to be close at 5, but indices will be traded till 9 p.m. because refined soya oil is a constitute of it, and it is going to be performed till 9 p.m. Okay. But on the expiry day, it is going to be settled and closed by 5 p.m. That is most important.
Okay.
And opening of the contract, it will be on the first day of the launch month.
Okay.
Number of active contracts as per the launch calendar, we are going to share with you. Then price limit. This is very interesting to understand that the initial price limit circuit in this will be 4% plus or minus. But it will be getting extended if the 15 minutes it is going to be traded at the same value, it is going to be extended to up to 6%. But the very interesting thing in this, that all the 10 constituents, all the 10 commodities underlying are having the 4% maximum circuit limit for a day.
Okay.
Okay. But indices will extend up to plus 2%, plus or minus.
Okay.
Yeah. Then positions limit for member, which will be 15% of the open interest or 10,000 lots. For every member maximum. And for the client, 5% of the total open interest and futures and 1,000 lots per client.
Okay.
For example, if it is for Nirmal Bank, so Nirmal Bank can make, as a member can take position of 15% of the total interest or 10,000 lots. Either side. Or for Nirmal Bank's clients, they can take maximum 5% position of the open interest or 1,000 lots, not more than that. Then FSP, FSP will be the most important thing. What will be the settlement price? As its underlying is the futures contract. So for that particular day, last working day of that particular contract of indices future, last hour 4 to 5 p.m. which will be considered as a, its average will be considered as a FSP. For example, soya oil and all the 10 constitutes, how they trade in last 1 hour for that particular expiry day, its average will be getting into the calculation, and that will be considered as a final settlement price for that particular contract of Adidas future. And minimum initial margin will be 4%.
So how much that will translate to roughly?
Around 4.5 lakhs total value of the contract is that. So around 18,000 to 19,000 will be the initial margin for the same. And
what is the average of volatility every day?
More than 1%.
More than 1%.
Between 1 to 1.5%. Yeah, between 1 to 1.5%.
So 4,500 rupees plus or minus conservatively will take place every day.
It's 1%, sir. So the value of the indices is around 900 and something. So it will be around 10 to 15 rupees.
Okay. Got it.
Yeah.
Next. So any queries anyone is having, because we'll be closing down.
So what I believe that if someone having any queries, we will wait till next 5 minutes. By the time I will explain one thing that how it is going to be benefit for all of us, that this is the first ever cash settled contract for agri commodities. You can take the overall directional trade into it. The most important thing, there is no bothering of the delivery or the additional margin or the delivery margin against the contract. The important thing is somebody taking position into the individual commodities, it is going to have a risk. So as a diversified basket, retail can trade into this.
Okay. Anyone please having any queries?
Is there any query?
No, I don't see any queries yet.
Everyone,
I think everyone's understood.
So, yes, Kunal sir, specific, do you have any, do you think anything to discuss?
No, I don't think so. There is very simple. It's like a Nifty. We are maybe finding what is this weightage and everything. You don't have to get into it. It is just for your understanding that each commodity is having certain weightage, and that is going to be on every 1st of April, that weightage will change, and that will be a look out at what is going to be the weightage. That is the SEBI's guide as per the same. So I don't think so there is any confusion. We wish NCDX success, and I hope this product is bringing lots of fortune to NCDX and to our investors.
Yes, sir, definitely. We are very looking forward to your participation into it as soon as it gets launched. And for any query, any doubt, or for any help or support, please reach out to me or Kunal sir. I request everyone that make the most out of it, and mind my words, this will be the game changer product for the agri commodities and the commodities market. Saying that, thank you once again everyone for participating into it and giving me a chance to speak to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Imran, for joining in as well and helping our viewers and participants actually understand the index, which will be launched in May. So we will be waiting for that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, everyone.